Welcome to part two of the Schoology Conferences video tutorial series. Schoology Conferences is a live video conferencing with students built into your Schoology course. Welcome to part two of this two-part video series. In part one, you learn how to use Schoology Conferences, looking at both the teacher and the student side. Now here in part two of the video, we're going to show you how to play the video if you use the Schoology Conference recording. That lets you keep the video in your course for 7 days. But in this video, we'll also show you how to use screencasting apps so you can actually record the whole session and post that to Schoology and to keep it in your course longer than the 7 days that the Schoology Conference recording button gives you. So let's get started seeing how you just use the play button for the 7 day recording, and then we'll look at the screencasting apps to record your whole session and how to post that to Schoology. All right, you can check on conferences. It might take a moment for the video to upload, but both students and teachers can go to the conferences within their course in Schoology. And if you click completed, you'll see that there's a play button now. So you can click that play button and it will play the video. This will be the same for teacher or students. A couple things that you have is right here, the three lines. You can jump to a certain section that was being shared out. You can also press your play to play the video. And in the bottom right-hand corner, you can toggle the different views, so you can switch the camera view and the annotation view. You can change the volume and you can go full screen. So we learned how you can use the Schoology Conference recording button that's built into conferences. And you just saw that you can get to that play button within your Schoology course. Just remember that video just stays there for 7 days. So maybe you want to create a video, record it to keep it past that 7 days. You can also use a screencasting app to record your live session instead of using the Schoology Conference recording button. So I'm going to show you two different ways. The first way I'm going to show you is in PowerPoint. That's right, PowerPoint on your device has in the insert tab a screen recording button. So it can do screencasting right there with the PowerPoint application you have already on your desktop. So I'll first show you that. Then the second way I'm going to show you is there's a tool called Loom, and it's an extension for your Chrome web browser. So it just installs right here. And I'll put in links in the video show notes how to install Loom, how to use it. And you can also apply for an educator account, which means you get the full version of Loom as an educator, which you're definitely going to get. Has no, it's unlimited time limits, unlimited what you can do with the screencasting app. So you're definitely going to want to get that. So first I'll show you PowerPoint, then I'll show you Loom. You can kind of choose what application you might like the best. So let's say you have your Schoology conference. Probably a good idea to get there about 5-10 minutes early, get all of your settings set up first in the conference. You know, make sure you go to the settings and maybe look through the lock views and lock down what you want before. Also use the plus button to maybe upload any of your documents, presentations that you want to use, kind of get it set up. But let's say you're ready to record this screen. So PowerPoint on your desktop right here, you can go to the insert tab at the very top, and over on the right hand side, there's a screen recording button. If you do not see this in PowerPoint on your device, you can send in a help desk request and just ask them to update PowerPoint on your desktop with the PowerPoint Office 365 click to run update version. Again, that's the Office 365 click to run update that you're gonna want, and that's where this will appear. So this is pretty cool. You just click on it, and then you're gonna draw a box around the area of the screen that you wanna record. You can record the full screen or just certain areas of the screen. So how you do that is right here, you click this select area button, and you get a little crosshair. And again, you can drag the full length of the screen. You can just drag in the area you want. So maybe I just wanna show the the chat that we're going to use, and the actual conference area that we're going to be in right here. So I just want to record this area. So it's up to you which area you want to record. And then when you're ready, you just click the record button. And the neat thing about PowerPoint, it's a screencasting tool. It's unlimited, has a countdown. And here we are. We're recording anything that you do in conferences. So anything that you do with any of these polls, sharing out presentations, videos, using the whiteboard, sharing your screen, all of this is being recorded in live time as you're doing it with the students, which is pretty cool. So let's say you're done recording. All you have to do is move your mouse to the top center, and you'll see a little drop down, and you just click the stop button right here, and then it will put it back into PowerPoint. So from here, all you do is you right click, and you're going to choose Save Media As, and just pick a location where you want to save the file, and then you're going to pick the file name. So I'll just put here Schoology Conference Recording. And then you might want to give it a title, a date and time, so you kind of know when it was done. And I'm just going to put it on my desktop for easy access right now, but you might want to be a little bit more organized, put it in your documents. And so I'll click Save. I'm going to come back here. Let's say the conference is all done. All I got to do is click the three dots and click End Meeting, and I end the conference session. So how do you put this recording in your Schoology course? So what you're going to want to do is right here with the Add Materials within your course, you can click Add File, and you're going to choose File, and you're going to choose Attach Files, and then you're going to choose that file. So I had put that on my desktop, and I called it, here we go, Screen Recording, Schoology Conference Screen Recording. And then it's going to upload. This is going to take a little moment, and be mindful that there is a max file size of 512 megabytes. So really long videos will be bigger than that. So you might be careful of how long the recorded video is for attaching it this method. So right after this uploads, I'll show you what the video will look like for you and your students in your course. But I'm also going to show you how you can use Google to upload your video to Google Drive and then put that in your course, especially for the longer videos that might be more than 512 megabytes in file size. All right, when it's all finished uploaded, just click the Add button and it adds it right to your course. So here's one of the video files I uploaded. So if you click on it, you're gonna see what this looks like. Teachers, students can play it right within the Schoology course right here. The play button, it's hosted here right within your Schoology course, which is pretty cool. So let's say again, it's that larger video file size and it's too big just to do the attach as the file that I just showed you with this Add Materials button. So we just did Add Materials and added it as a file. So let's say it's too large. So what you can do is you can go to google.com. In the right-hand corner, you're gonna wanna make sure you sign in with your district account. Then I'm gonna go to the waffle, and that's how I get to Google Drive. And then from Google Drive, I'm gonna create a folder because I'm gonna be wanting to do several of these recordings throughout time, so I want an organized place to put those in. So I'll click New, and I'll click Folder, and I'll call this My Schoology Conference Recordings. And then I'll click Create, and it's going to create that folder for me. So now I'm going to go to that folder, and I can start uploading my video files here. So how I do that is just New, File Upload. I'm going to choose where that video file is at. So I have put it in my desktop. Here it is. And I open it, and it's going to upload that file. It might take a moment as well, especially larger files of videos do take longer. You're gonna see the progress here. All right, when it's all uploaded, you'll see the file. All you have to do is right click on it and go to Share. And then what you're gonna do is you're going to right here where it says where it's restricted, just click Change the Link.
And right now it's set to anyone in Modesto City Schools can view it. So what that means is when they click on it, they'll have to log in with their district email address and password to see this video. So you might want to keep it protected that way, but you might just want to put it in your course. They click on it, they can see it. So all you have to do is change it right here. Just click the drop down, choose anyone with the link, and just make sure it says just viewers and click done. And then all you have to do is right click on it one more time, go back to share, and you're going to have a copy button right here. So then you copy the link. And then you're going to like this. In Schoology, all you have to do is click Add Materials, click Add File Link, and you're going to want to make sure you choose Link. And then you just paste in, so you can right-click and paste the web link that you had just copied and give it a title, say My Video. And then you want to make sure you click this off. It says Display in Schoology. Looks like a little newspaper icon. Well, make sure you click that so it's not turned on, and then click Add, and here it is. So let's go see what happens. Well, so when students click on the video right here, they click on it, it just pops open, and they can play it right away, right within their web browser, which is pretty cool. So this is one way that you can add it. So remember, if it's a small video file, you can just use Add Materials, Add a File. If it's a larger video file, make sure you upload it to your Google Drive first and set those share properties and copy the link. And then you can just add it to your Schoology course as a link. All right, so that's one method for screencasting. That's free. It's PowerPoint's already on your device. The second way that I wanted to show you is Loom. Again, this is Loom for Chrome. It's a Chrome extension that you can install from the Chrome Web Store. And we'll put links to installing it, also links how to use it, and a link for registering for your Educator Pro account in this video show notes. So pretty much how this would work. So say you had your conference going on. You might like this. It's a little bit easier steps than what I showed you for the PowerPoint route. So you got your Schoology conference, and all you do is you click the Loom extension, and then you just click screen only right here, and you click start recording, and then you click the screen and click share, and it has another little countdown. And it's recording everything you're doing. So it's going to record just the same. It's just recording everything you do in Schoology conferences, everything that you say, everything that's happening. This one, when you're all done, you would just click stop right here. Well, this little toolbar might be in your way of the other tools, so you can click hide. Here's where you can also stop it. You can click the check mark right here. So you have a couple different ways to kind of stop the recording. That you do. So let's say I'm all done recording, I just click finish, and then it automatically hosts it for you within the Loom extension. Again, Loom is just an extension in Chrome. The first time you use it, it just asks you to sign in with your Google account, just use your district email account. Make sure you apply for that Educator Pro edition. You can give a different title right here. So this is where you type the title. And then you can look at a couple other things. There's some settings that you can set. If I go to settings right here, and you can kind of choose what, if you want students to add comments to it, you probably want to turn some of this off. If you can let them vote with these emojis, so if they liked it or not, you can even choose if the person can download, we can turn that off. And you can turn off, they don't need to know how many people watch the video. So you might turn off a couple of those settings. And then you pretty much just click copy link right here. You can also get the embed code if you go here to share. And I'll show you that next, the embed code. So let's say I just wanted to copy the link. So pretty much in Schoology, I can click add materials. I can click add file link. Click a link, paste in my web link here, give it a title, and you give it a title, maybe the topic and the date and time. Remember to always click off this icon and click Add. So now it's here, and I'll show you what happens. So students will be able to click on that link, and they're going to be able to see the video. It pops open in its own tab, and they'll be able to see the video and play it. They won't have all of these settings. These are because I'm still logged in my account. They'll just see the video, and if you have chosen to turn on the emoji voting, they can do that as well, and they'll see your title. But they'll be able to play the video. So let's say you want to get a little bit more fancy. So we had looked at, you can use the copy link right here, but you can also go down here. This is another way to share it in your Schoology course. It's called embed. So if you click the link for embed, click fixed, click copy the code, and then in your Schoology course, you can click add materials, add a page, and you give it a title. And then the biggest thing here, you're going to click on the second dot, and this is where you paste it, and then we'll click create. And let's see what this looks like. So the embed makes it live here in Schoology. So when a student clicks on it to look at the video, they're going to see that the video is right here in Schoology. They don't leave it to play the video, which is pretty neat. Another option that you had there is, if I go back to the settings gear and edit, another option you had is if we click this little document here in this page material, this lets it display right there in the course. So you'll see it just displays right here in the inline with the course. You might like that feature, but you might not like it as well. It might be too many videos or crowded, just depending on if you want the students just to click play, or they actually have to click on this material to see the video. So those are a couple options that you have. One is using PowerPoint to do just screen recording, uploading it to Schoology or into Google Drive and sharing the link out, or using Loom, where you can use the Loom extension right here. And then this just becomes a link that you can copy, or an embed code with this arrow right here that you can copy and embed it into your course. Again, Loom is probably the easiest route. Once you got installed, got your Pro Educator account, just to copy the link and share that. You can get a little bit more fancy when you're ready to do the embeds with the embed code. So I hope that helps with a couple more ideas how you can screencast and record your Schoology conference screens and put those in Schoology. The same methods I just showed you are how you can screencast anything. So maybe it's an app or a website, and how you can put that in Schoology as well. So these same skills you just learned right now isn't just uniquely to just screen recording a Schoology conference, but you just learned how to screencast in general using PowerPoint and Loom, that you can put those videos. So it could be screen recording how to use a website or application, or showing something on your screen and putting that video in Schoology. Thanks.